great music now to ease you into this Tuesday morning. We're joined this morning by Belinda Carlisle, her new single, Into Deep Love. Belinda Carlisle, Into Deep there, who we're now going to have a chat with. That record produced, recorded and mixed by a man with a very funny name.
Go on.
David Tickle. David, is that right? Is that right, Belinda? David Tickle.
Yeah. David, I know everybody says that when they say his name, don't they? They go,
yeah. Because I was thinking to myself, now that's a re-release. That's because I was told that it's only in the shops from yesterday.
Yesterday, yeah.
But they've been playing this on the radio here for an eternity.
I know.
Really well. It's a very, very good tune. So
when did you first record it then?
It was recorded in October, November. We started the album then and finished in March, so sometime in between.
Yeah. We were looking before the commercial break. We had a whole string of your hits put together in a compilation there. Oh, there were a lot of them. Is it becoming more difficult or is it easier the longer you're in the business to churn out hits?
Well, it's always hard to find a good song, and they're difficult to find. They're hard to come by. But luckily, I have somebody I work with, Rick Knowles, who wrote lots of my hits, and he wrote this one too.
It's 15 years since your days in the Go-Go's. Do you miss those days?
I miss the camaraderie of that sort of band and the girls and whatever. But for the most part, I'm glad I'm on my own, and I don't. I can't really see myself getting back into a band.
What is the key to actually moving on in this business? Because there are many people who are in bands, but once the band splits up, that's it really. They don't move on.
Right.
What has been your secret?
I think it's. I mean, I do think there's an element of luck and timing, and I do think that my voice, although it may not be perfect, it is definitely distinctive, and that has carried me through almost 20 years.
You have, in a way, reinvented yourself and your look and your image, and I mean, you're very 90s, you're very now. Do you think that has helped? You haven't been stuck in a time warp?
I hope not. I don't know. I've like anybody, you go through changes and you go through your little phases and things, and I hope I'm not like I was 15, 20 years ago. And
you look better, actually.
Well, I think I feel better for the most part. Uh-huh. So it's a natural progression of getting older and
you're a mummy. You're a mummy now.
Being
of
a mom.
Yeah, yeah. And he's little James Duke. Duke Mason, named after his famous granddad.
Granddad,
the actor James Mason.
Right.
And you now live in France.
Right.
So how did that come about, and why did you uproot from LA?
Well, first of all, I didn't think that I would be able to offer my son the type of childhood quality childhood living in that city, because it's too dangerous and. It's not, it's not what it was when I lived and I grew. Mm-hmm. I was born and raised there, so that for that reason. And then the earthquake, and after the earthquake happened on a Monday, we left on Friday, and
that was it.
That was it. I've been through earthquakes before, but not like that. And it was time. I mean, I just I don't really care for LA anymore, and I don't know if I'll live in France forever, but. For right now, it's fine.
It's the place.
And the quality of life is good.
It's different. Yeah, I think it's better. Some people wouldn't agree, but it's definitely different.
Well, listen, you're certainly, you mightn't be in too deep, but we hope In Too Deep shakes the charts. And
we've
enjoyed listening and talking to you
this
morning, Belinda. Thank you for coming in.
Yeah.
Even though it is an ungodly hour, but sure, it's worth it in the end, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
What should we say?
Now then, Mr. M's Roadshow.